boxing legend, James Toney. So James, I gotta ask you this. What do you think about Evander Holyfield, the real deal?
Pretty fun.
Nice guy?
Well, I don't know about his personality, but he was cool until he fought me. We saw what happened. I mind him because he not let people tell him real quick. You know what I'm saying? In this game, you gotta be your own man. What's up, baby? How you doing, sweetie? Okay? You gotta be put in your own time. Don't never let nobody run you out when you ain't ready to go. I think he's been able to win lately, so he's part of the opposition. So it is what it is.
What do you think about George Foreman?
I love George. George opened doors for people like me. And he won the title when he was 40 years old. I'm one of the reigning world champions of the world. I'm 42 years old. I'm 43 August. I'm fighting better than ever.
All right, what do you think about such a heavyweight like Muhammad Ali?
Huh?
Ali, what do you think about Muhammad Ali?
Ali was a great heavyweight. He wasn't the greatest fighter of all time.
Who's the greatest of all time, in your opinion?
Man, you know better. It's Sugar Robinson. Ali.
That's Patty. What Floyd Sr. and Roger always tell me.
Man, Ray Robinson, Ezra Charles, those are probably the two greatest fighters of all time because Ray Robinson, you know, he did it all. He won the first what? He won the first 211 fights. 140 by knockout. Incredible. You know what I'm saying? Ed Charles, he was number one contender. For people in boxing historians, you can go back and check it out yourself. Ed Charles was the number one middleweight contender in the world for 10 years. But Ray Robinson was the champion. Ray didn't want to fight.
Yeah, I know.
And then he was the number one light heavyweight contender in the world for 5 years. Nobody wanted to fight him. He didn't get a shot at the title until he was 30 years old when he was heavyweight.
You're not getting a lot of fights now. What does that say?
It scared me. I strike fear in everybody's heart. I'm an old school fighter, you know. I'm not the type of person who's gonna die off people by ass. But like I said, I'm probably retired. I want all the belts. I don't care if it's an ABC belt. I don't want nobody being claimed as a champion in the world but me.
So what do you think about Mike Tyson? Mike Tyson, what do you think about him?
Oh, I love Mike. Mike was a heavyweight coming up. Great person. The glad he's come back the way he has. It's great for society. And other than that, I wish him well. I wish him the best. I love Mike.
Have you seen the show with the pigeons?
No, I'm not into animals, man.
Yeah, how about Hangover? Hangover 1 and 2?
Oh, I love that. Hey, he was funny as hell in Hangover.
Can you sing and dance or not really?
Huh?
Can you dance? He was dancing and singing.
No, I can't dance. I don't dance a boogie. What's up, baby? How you doing?
How's it going?
Good. What's up? You ready to fight or something?
Ready, brother.
You sure? Who
ready to fight? Ready to cut these guns out.
Who wants to fight?
Whoever, brother.
You sure?
Uh-oh. Watch out, man.
Yeah, what's up, man? How you doing?
Nephew.
That's a real heavyweight champ. That's the heavyweight champ right there.
The heavyweight champ of what? San Fernando?
No.
Van Nuys?
LA, brother.
LA.
Yeah, LA.
Los Angeles. Well, thank God he don't come to Detroit. He's safe.
What would happen if he went to Detroit?
It wouldn't be a good look for him.
Brother, I'm from South Central LA. It ain't nothing like Detroit, brother.
You're right. You're right. Ain't nothing like Detroit. You get Detroit, you ain't coming back, dude.
Brother, you walk through the jungles of LA.
I'm going to say this right here. We don't have all these gyms out here, Mexicans and all of Detroit. So if you see somebody of color in the city of Detroit after 6 o'clock, you better run. I like LA, you know what? Ain't nothing about LA but the weather and the women. Even though I'm married though. I love LA.
I guess you haven't been to LA lately then. Go to LA, brother. Ain't nothing nice.
LA, he said LA ain't nothing nice. That man ain't up in Detroit, so you know, he said what he said. I've been to LA. I said
what parts though?
I've been to South Central, I've been to Compton, Nah, you know what? I go visit the centers over there.
Where?
I go visit the centers. The kids be in this all the time. So I've seen the poverty. Everything has a poverty. Everything is different. You know what I'm saying?
I say it's crazy everywhere, bro.
It's crazy. You know, it's crazy. You see, the thing we miss about it, that we spend so much time sending money to other countries, we ain't putting our country first. You know, help our communities. Help our land myself. My man, I'm here to tell you right here. It's an LA resident. He don't like what's going on in LA. He lives it.
Brother, so, I know, brother.
See, he knows. He said like it is.
Hey, if I got holes in my back for a reason, 9 millimeters.
You got holes? Where?
In the back, brother.
Can I see?
You're acting like the police right now with that camera.
you see, and that's why I like going to the hoods and seeing people, because that's what I do. Somewhere James turned rich and fabulous. Man, I love going, because I'm a real person. I want to go to the hood, because I came up in the hood.
I want you to come on the camera, too.
Okay.
Talk to us.
We are talking to 11-time world champion James Toney. He's a boxing legend. He's a person that some fighters don't want to fight, but here's someone who wants to face him. Let me ask him. Are you not scared to get in there with James Toney?
Hey.
No?
Rookie. You going in there? Uh-oh. You ready to win? You know my Tyson over there, right? Yeah, hey, rookie. Put my gloves on. This is a smartphone.
So there you have it, 11-time world champion James Toney from Esnewsreporting.com from the IFC gym in Van Nuys.
You don't find no more?
Reporting.
You don't find no more?